Hey yogis, welcome back. My name is Marissa. I will be guiding you through today a mermaid focused flow. We'll also be focusing on some core strength, hip opening, and shoulder opening. So I hope you brought some energy. We're gonna get started in tabletop pose. So hands and knees, hands underneath the shoulders, knees underneath your hips, coming right into cat and cow. Inhale, drop the belly, lift the gaze, curl your tailbone up, really engage your back muscles here. Exhale, round for your cat pose, zip your low belly in and up. Come forward through to cow. Exhale, round for cat. Take cat and cow at your own pace. So mermaid is a little bit of hip opening. It's a little bit of a back bend. There's some shoulder opening and quad opening. So a lot's going on in this pose. If you have particularly tight hips, like your hips not on the ground in pigeon pose, like majority of us, definitely have your blocks nearby today. That will make this pose a lot more accessible for you. Take a few more rounds here. Really feeling out your spine, your core, your arms and shoulders. And when you're ready, meet me in a neutral tabletop pose. Coming right into low lunge, so just step your right foot forward any way you like. You can scrub your left knee back a bit. Come up one hand at a time, hips push forward and down. Notice here in your first low lunge how you can feel your left thigh opening. There should be a pinch in the front of the right hip, and you're really using your strength to push your hips forward. Once you're feeling strong here, both of your arms can reach straight up for your low crescent lunge. Hands can frame your right foot. Step back tabletop and left foot comes forward. So just changing sides. Same thing. Get adjusted how you need. I like to scrub my right knee back a little bit. And then come up one hand at a time onto your left knee. Hips push forward and down. Looking for that stretch in your right thigh. Pinch in your left hip. Chest is nice and tall and open. Once you're feeling strong, arms float straight up. Really lift up out of your waist here. And just breathe. Hands frame your left foot. You can step back to tabletop pose, but really we're coming right into down dog. Unfold into your down dog however you like. Taking a few breaths here to really pedal it out. I'm practicing first thing in the morning, so everything's really tight for me. But I promise this class will loosen everything up and you're gonna be sore. I did this class on today's Saturday. I did it Wednesday and I actually am still sore. So we do a lot of core strengthening today. One more breath here. And on your next inhale, right leg rises as high as you can get it. Step it in between your palms for a high crescent lunge. So left knee's off the ground. You can come up onto your right knee to start. I know it's still early. And then both arms reach straight up. Gaze is up. Really sink into your hips here. left arm forward, right arm back. Take it into a twist. Arms are straight and open. Still breathing through your nose. Back through center, high crescent. Hands frame your right foot. Straighten your right leg. Bend your left knee. Spring forward for a fold. Let your head be heavy. Sweep your arms behind your lower back. Interlace your fingers. Lock out your elbows. And let your hands come up and over. Shoulders stretch. Body weight in the toes. Hold it here. With the strength of your arms, start to pull yourself up to stand. Keep a flat back. Once you stand up straight, release your fingers. Reach your arms up, push your hips forward, and take it into a back bend. Exhale, dive forward and down. Straight legs, straight spine, and hands plant. Your right foot's gonna step back. Left foot meets it. Down dog. Come forward through to plank pose. And lower all the way to your belly, nice and slow. Untuck your toes. Hands wide and forward of your shoulders. Press into your palms for cobra. Really magnetize your hips down. Look up. This is a deep back bend. So be gentle early on. And release. Coming back through high plank. So hips are off the ground a little bit. Hands plant. Just press straight up. Use your core strength. And meet me in down dog. Left leg rises nice and high. Step it through in between your palms, high crescent. So both toes face forward. Walk your hands up onto your left knee, one at a time. Hips are pushing forward and down. Left thigh parallel to the floor if you can. Once you're grounded here, arms reach straight up for your high crescent lunge. So really it's the same thing we did earlier, we just have our knee off the ground, which is a little bit more challenging. Right arm forward, left arm back, twist. Open it up. Back through center. Hands frame your left foot, straighten your left leg. Bend your right knee, spring forward for a fold. Suck your stomach in. Swim your arms behind your back, interlace your fingers, lock your elbows, let your arms fall up and over. Pull yourself up to stand with the strength of your arms, flat back. Release the interlace of the fingers, arms reach up, take it into a back bend, hips push forward. Dive forward and down. Hands plant. Left foot steps back. Right foot meets it. Down dog. Come forward through the plank pose. Lower all the way to your belly. Untuck your toes. Hands wide and forward of the shoulders. Press into the palms. Lift your chest for a cobra. Glue your hips down. Look up. Exhale, release. Coming back through high plank, hips lift off the ground. Toes are tucked. Press straight up. And back to down dog. All right, so we're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna add on a little bit. And we're gonna take our full vinyasa. So open up your ears. You got this. Right leg rises. Step it through for your high crescent lunge. Come up one hand at a time. Sit a little bit lower into that right hip. arms reach straight up, high crescent. Left arm forward, right arm back, twist. Back through center, high crescent, hands frame your right foot. Straighten your right leg, bend your left knee, spring forward, fold. This time, inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold. Same thing, hands behind your back. Arms come up and over. Pull yourself up to stand, but instead of releasing the interlace, pull yourself into a back bend. Hips push forward, and your head can drop back. Dive forward and down. Keep the interlace the whole time. And release at the end, hands plant. Right foot steps back. Left foot meets it, down dog. Come forward through the plank and hold it. About 5 breaths in plank. Really zip your low belly in and up. Gaze forward. Last breath. Lower halfway, chaturanga. Untuck your toes, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Left leg rises nice and high. Step it through, high crescent. Come up as slow as you'd like onto your left knee, or get straight into it and reach your arms up. Depends on your energy level. Right arm forward, left arm back. Twist. And back through center, high crescent. Hands frame your left foot, straighten your left leg, bend your right knee, spring forward, fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold. Hands behind your back. Arms come up and over. With the help of your arms, pull yourself up to stand and pull yourself into a back bend. Keep the interlace, push your hips forward, drop your head back. Dive forward with the interlace. Keep your legs straight. And hands release at the end. Left foot steps back. Right foot meets it, down dog. Coming into high plank, holding it for 5 breaths. You got it. Just hold here and breathe. Don't droop your hips down or have them way up high. Really use your core. If your wrist hurt in down dog or vinyasas, it's honestly because you're not using enough core strength. Unless, of course, you have some arthritis issues, then it's happening for other reasons. But I notice when I'm really focused on my core, my wrists don't hurt, my shoulders don't burn as much, but my core burns a lot more. So focus on that here, one more breath. Using your core, lower halfway. Up dog, untuck your toes, and down dog. All right, hold your down dog, 5 breaths. Before we get into our flow, make sure you're breathing in through your nose and out through your nose. Let your breathing be normal. If down dog's too much, take a child's pose. Last breath. And let's all meet in down dog. Getting into our flow. Right leg rises nice and high. Step it into warrior 2, so back foot parallel with the short edge, but don't come up yet. Stay nice and low. Walk to the inside of your right leg, bow your head forward, really sink into that right hip. just breathe. If your right knee's coming in, push it open. You can always feel my bones like clicking into place when I do that. On your inhale, rise up into warrior two. Sit wide and low. Reverse your warrior. Left arm down, right arm up. And take your right hand, or left hand, swim it behind your back to catch your right thigh. So this is a half bind. Just hold it here. Start to straighten your right leg. Tip forward into triangle pose. So keep the half bind. No rush to get in the triangle. Gazing up. Release your left arm for your more traditional triangle pose. Both hands frame your right foot for a low lunge. Straighten your right leg, bend your left knee, spring forward, fold at the top of your mat. Hips sit back, chair pose, arms reach up. Exhale, dive forward fold. Inhale, half lift, right foot steps back, and left foot meets it, down dog. Coming forward through to plank, don't take your vinyasa yet. More core work. This time, right leg rises about a foot and a half off the ground, maybe 2 feet. Start to squeeze your right knee in towards your right tricep shoulder area. Send it straight back, float it, squeeze it in, send it back, squeeze it in, send it back. I think that's three, squeeze it in, four, going for five, and five, squeeze it in. Coming into high plank, either going right to down dog or take your vinyasa, chaturanga, up dog, down dog. Nice work. Left leg rises and step it through warrior two legs. So back foot's parallel with the short edge of your mat. Walk your hands forward to the inside of your left leg. Bow your head down. Just breathe. Start to rise up into warrior two. Get grounded. Reverse your warrior. Left arm comes up, right arm down. Take your right hand behind your lower back and catch your left thigh. If you can. If you can't, your hand can just face out. Go as far as you can get it. Start to straighten your left leg, keep the wrap, coming into triangle pose. Go forward nice and slow. Left arm down, gazing up. Right arm reaches up, both arms straight. Both hands frame your left foot, low lunge. Straighten your left leg, bend your right knee, spring forward, fold. Hips sit back, chair pose. Exhale, dive forward, hands plant. Inhale, half lift, pull out all the kinks. and left foot steps back. Right foot meets it, down dog. Come forward through the plank and hold it. So same thing on the left side. Left foot's gonna flow up. Left knee squeezes in towards the left upper arm. Send it back. Squeeze it in. Send it back. Three. Four. Last one. Five. And take your vinyasa, chaturanga, up dog, down dog. Hold your down dog and breathe. Right leg rises nice and high. Step it through warrior two. Back foot parallel. Dive forward. Really opening up that right thigh. Press your knee open again if you need. Come up to warrior two. Sit nice and low. And then reverse your warrior. Take the wrap with your left arm, maybe catch your right thigh. Look up. Straighten your right leg. Tip into triangle pose. Left arm floats up. Both hands frame your right foot, low lunge. Straighten your right leg, bend your left knee, spring forward and fold. Hips sit back, chair pose. Exhale, dive forward. Right foot steps back, left foot meets it, down dog. And just take your full vinyasa this time. Plank, chaturanga, up dog, down dog. So moving a little quicker. Left leg rises, step it through. Warrior two. Dive forward and down. Rise up. For your actual warrior two. Reverse your warrior, right hand behind your back. Catch your left thigh if you can. Tip back a little further, really find your back bend here. And straighten your front leg for triangle pose. You can float your right arm up. Both hands frame your left foot, low lunge. Straighten your left knee, bend your, or straighten your left leg, bend your right knee, spring forward, fold. Hips sit back, chair. And dive forward. Left foot steps back. Right foot meets it, down dog. Taking your vinyasa, plank, chaturanga. Up dog and down dog. All right, we're gonna take some down dog crunches. So if you haven't done these before, watch me. It's a really simple move. We'll get you really strong and kind of rippling forward, throw down dog to plank. So what we're gonna do is just come forward halfway, almost so that our spine is really rounded like cat pose. Then just go back to down dog. Come forward halfway, really squeeze your core. Suck your stomach in. Back to down dog, that's two. Halfway, come forward. Down dog, three. Four. We're going for 15. Five. Six. Seven. Stay with my pace. Eight. Suck your stomach in. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, last one, 15, hold it. Suck your stomach in, really hold it. And down dog. Take a quick child's pose, or just sit on your knees, shake your arms out. I know it's a lot on the shoulders. Just get readjusted here for a second. All right, and we'll meet in down dog. We'll do some closing poses. Well, we'll do some more opening poses before we attempt mermaid. So find your way to down dog. We're gonna do some deep stretching. And then we're gonna prep for mermaid and we're gonna do mermaid. Right leg rises. Take it into warrior one. So your back foot's at a 45 degree angle and your arms just reach straight up. We're not in warrior one for long. Just swing your arms behind your back and release the fingers like we did earlier. Pull your chest open. This time, coming into humble warrior. So we're kind of combining those two poses. We're diving to the inside of our right thigh. Arms come up and over. Really deep hip opener. Deep shoulder opener. A little bit of everything here. Hold it. Really breathe into that hip. Carry yourself up with the help of your hands, like we did at the beginning of class, and straighten both legs. Square off your hips. Readjust your stance if you need for pyramid pose. Shine your chest open. Inhale. Exhale, dive forward. Keep your legs straight. Come down as much as you can. Think about leaning more towards your right thigh. So you want to touch your chest on your shin, stomach on your thigh. Once you're as low as you can get it, just let your head be heavy and breathe. Go ahead, send your legs straight up and back, tripod down dog. Take your right knee to your right wrist. Setting up for pigeon. So I would recommend using a block in this pigeon today because that's how we're going to set up our supported mermaid. So take your block and put it right under your right hip. If you have another block, take it towards the front of your mat. We're going to do like a really modified mermaid first. Scrub your left leg back a little bit. Take your right forearm to that block and your left hand's gonna reach back for your left toes. So it's kind of a quad stretch pigeon pose. This is similar feeling to mermaid. So just sink into it here. Get adjusted how you need and breathe. Mermaid pose, I think, always can look really complicated when you see it in pictures, but once you break it down kind of step by step, it's actually a pretty accessible pose, and there are so many modifications. So I really like the use of a block in it, since I think that's the biggest hurdle is balance. So I think you guys will really, really like getting into it this way. Pull your foot in towards your glute one more time, and release. Meet me in down dog, however you like. Keep your blocks nearby, but set them out of the way for now. No vinyasa, just let the blood come back to that right hip, knee, ankle. And left leg rises. Stepping it through for warrior one. So same things, back foot at a 45 degree angle, arms reach up. Our favorite pose, hands behind the back, pull your chest open. Diving to the inside of your left thigh. Keep your spine as straight as you can on the way down. Then use your shoulder to kind of push the knee out of the way. Head is heavy. Just a couple breaths here. Keep your eyes open. Pull yourself up to stand with the strength of your arms. Hands come to your hips. Maybe reduce your stance a little bit. Square off your hips. Chest is open, elbows back, and dive towards your left thigh for pyramid. Again, trying to touch your stomach on the thigh, chest on the knee, and your face on the leg below the knee. Hands forward. Keep your eyes open. And keep your breathing normal. Hands plant. Send your left leg straight up and back to tripod down dog. Take your left knee, left wrist, pigeon. Might need to scrub your right leg back a little bit. It's kind of a short down dog. And then take your block underneath your left hip, just like we did on the right side. Get adjusted here. Take your left forearm to the block and right hand reaches back for your right toes. Quad stretch. So again, this might feel really intense, but this is kind of simulating mermaid, and mermaid's an intense pose. So if you can't quite get your mermaid today when we're attempting, come back here. Just take some time opening up your quad, hips, shoulders, and I promise you will get there one day. Sometimes poses can seem so unattainable, but when we really focus on opening up our body with intention, you will be amazed what can happen. And go ahead, release, meet me in down dog. Stretch it out, and we are going to try our mermaid pose. All right. So right knee, right wrist. Pigeon on the right side to start. Pigeon is really the foundation of mermaid. Scrub your left leg back. So you should only really need one block for mermaid, but if your hip's super high up, take two blocks under your right hip. Okay, so get your block there just like we did earlier. Kind of walk yourself forward and reach back for your left toes with your left hand. Okay, pull it in. Once you're in pretty good, see if you can kind of slide your foot to the left elbow crease. Okay, so our left forearm's pretty freed up. If you're good there, right arm's gonna reach up, come behind your head to meet the left. Try to touch the fingers, just grip them together, and then pull your chest forward. Find a back bend. It's a little tricky. And breathe five breaths. This is my tighter side. My left side's definitely my better side for mermaid. You might find that too, so don't be discouraged if this is like really tight on your right side. One more breath. And slowly release, coming into pigeon, and then going into down dog. I will not have you hold your pigeon. Let the blood come back to the right knee and ankle. Maybe move your hips side to side. Shake it out. And let's take it into mermaid on the left. So left knee, left wrist. Just set up for your normal pigeon pose. Scrub your right leg back. And slip your block or shoe under your left hip. For a little support. Reach back with your right hand. Grab your right toes. Start to bring your foot to the elbow crease area of your right hand or right arm. Left arm reaches up to meet your right fingertips. Pull your chest forward. Use some strength here. And you might find you start to flow off the block a little bit. That's when you know you got the balance. It's tricky though. I can only get it on one side and not for very long. So do what you can. Find your back bend. Keep your chin and chest up and look up. Three more breaths. And release. Nice work. Meet me in a down dog, however you like, no rush. Let's take a vinyasa plank, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. From your down dog, just come to your forearms. Dolphin, walk your feet in. Suck your stomach in, breathe. And hold it. Three more breaths. Really use your core strength here. If you're working on headstand, this is the right pose for you to practice. Walk your feet back, forearm plank, and then just lower your hips down. Coming into Sphinx, untuck your toes, pull your elbows back towards your hips, peel your chest open. Feel a nice stretch in your core. And I know what you're thinking. That wasn't that much core work. We're not done. There is more coming. So don't you worry. Meet me back in down dog however you like, either through tabletop, child's pose, whatever feels good for you. I will see you there. But this is our last down dog. So make it the best. Think about trying to touch your forehead to the mat. Sit your hips up higher. Suck your stomach in more. Look forward and just baby step your way to the top of your mat. Coming into a nice juicy fold. Inhale, half lift. And fold. Should be nice and open up for this now. Reverse one dive, come up flat back and palms touch above your head. Come up high onto your toes, hands can come to heart center, and slowly elevator yourself down. So hips are tucked in, like we're gonna sit our hips onto our heels. I like to call this the elevator. I don't know if that's really what it's called, it just makes sense to me. Once your hips are on your heels, reach your arms forward. Sit your hips back so that you take a seat into boat pose. I know, everybody's favorite pose. Shins parallel to the mat, chest forward, float your palms up. We're gonna go to low boat to high boat 10 times. Okay, so I will count. Stay with my rhythm. Inhale, high boat. Exhale, low boat. Inhale, high boat. Exhale, low boat. Two. Inhale, high boat. Exhale, low boat. Three. High boat. Low boat. Four. High boat. Low boat. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. 10, hold it. Don't kill me. 10. 9. Hold your low boat. Suck your stomach in. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. High boat. I guess that was 11. And then you can just lower to your back. Send your legs straight up. Palms face down. Kind of bring your arms underneath your hips. So your hips are kind of right on the tops of your hands. Legs are up straight. Inhale, breathing. We're gonna do 10 leg drops, so 10 each side. Changing sides left to right. So left leg down, one. Right leg down, two. Don't let your heel touch the mat. Left leg down, three. Right down, four. Left, five. Right, six. Left, seven. Right, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, keep breathing, last one, 20. Bring it up and just take your feet down. Take your arms out to a T, palms face down. Let's come into a twist and officially close class. So shins parallel to the mat. Just drop your knees over to the right side. You can kind of anchor your right knee, your knees down with your right hand. You can look to the left. Just breathe. We really opened a lot of different parts of the body today. So a lot of shoulder opening, a lot of hip opening, quad opening, core work. We did a good amount of arm work too, just with the vinyasas and planks. So there's really a lot to be proud of today. If you didn't get your mermaid pose, please don't be discouraged. I don't think many people get their mermaid pose on their first try, unless they're like an ex-dancer or something. So please don't be discouraged. You will get it. Sometimes all you just need is a regular yoga practice. Go ahead, change sides so knees float to the left. Left hand to the knees, anchor them down, and gaze to the right. Let me know if your core is sore tomorrow. I was actually surprised. I didn't think this was too much core work, but I think since I was just so focused on making it strong, since it was like short stints, it really did me good. And I honestly prefer to do less core work and get more bang for my buck. So I always just really try when I'm doing core work to make sure I give it my all, because it is my least favorite, but I absolutely love arm balances, I love inversions, and those require a lot of core strength. So I try to work on it because it makes my head balances a lot easier. So if you're someone like me who just loves to float and play around like that, definitely core strength is gonna be your friend there. Less injuries, I promise. Come back to center, palms face up, arms in close, legs straight. Feet fall open and eyes closed for Shavasana. So Shavasana is called corpse pose, dead body pose, and part of the pose is closing your eyes. It's to remove one of the senses and make you more dead-like. So I hope you guys have a wonderful day. I hope you enjoyed this flow as much as I did. This is a really fun one for me. And as always, I hope to see you back soon. If you have any questions, drop me a comment or message me on Instagram. And I look forward to seeing you back soon, yogis. Namaste.